ebo ko ni fun awo ku ti o sun ninu Oluwa nitori won o ba Jesu jinde.
Life is like a pilgrimage with definite entry and exit date. For late Chief D.O Akanle, who entered this world on November 10, 1933, his exit April 4, 2018, was more comforting to his family members and friends who believed that the patriarch of Akanle family had gone to a more glorious home. He lived life to its fullest and was celebrated by his family, friends and the society. As part of the order of service for his funeral rites, which began with a night of tributes on Monday, service of songs on Tuesday and Wednesday by the chorister of St. Thomas Anglican Church, Isikon Akure, witnessed by several dignitaries who had come to recount the unforgettable memories of the man many described as disciplined, honest and kind-hearted. Earlier on Thursday, his body leaves mortuary at Bell Funeral Home to his residence at Kidemak Junction, Akure.
It's been a long day without you, my friend, and I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way.
Later, a commendation service was held in his honor at St. Thomas Anglican Church, Isikon, Akure.
He was full of love, and I'm sure those who have the pleasure of coming his way will testify to this.
Where the deceased children were joined by family members, friends, colleagues and neighbors to celebrate the late patriarch of the Akanle family. That same day, Thursday 24th May 2018, the peaceful town of Ikoyi-Ikole in the Ikole local government of Ekiti State played host to guests from all walks of life. Where scores of family members, friends, colleagues besieged his residence in Ikoyi-Ikole, his hometown, for his burial rites and pay their last respects.
When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away.
A wake-up service was held at his hometown. During his eventful lifetime, as an extraordinary being, he was known for his value and hardcore discipline. His honesty and integrity is second to none. A cheerful giver, who has inspired and impacted the life of so many in his church and community. That was the body of late Chief D.O Akanle as he made history to the auditorium of St. James Anglican Church, Ikole, Ekiti. In the comment of the vicar, he described late Chief D.O Akanle as a man of integrity, discipline and Christian with family values. His contribution to church growth is worthy of emulation. Many people believed that the account of Chief D.O Akanle would not be complete without drawing the necessary lesson, especially from his background. He loved education, was an avid writer, and believed education is the best asset to ever give to your children. He was patron to the choir in St. Thomas Anglican Church, Akure, and St. James Church, Ikole, Ekiti. He was a long-time secretary of the YMCA at St. Thomas Anglican Church, Akure. He served the various communities he lived and worked in. And for his selfless service, he was instituted as the Babagua of Udeimele, the Aparishi of Ikoyi, Ikole, Ekiti, and the Ashuraju of St. James Church, Ikoyi, Ikole, Ekiti. At the end of the church service, D.O Akanle body was carried in a motorcade to his residence, where his remains was committed to Mother Earth.
Hello, I am a group performing from the Igbo tribe. I believe one of the children of Baba is married to an Igbo person, which brought out about this performance this afternoon. Now we can see them, they've been performing. They are Loaye group. They are awesome.
The life and time of this man seems to have been defined by his close affinity with people of different persuasion, the old and the young, poor and rich. He was a very loyal, dependable man, especially to his friends, family and associates.
You can see around here we've been enjoying ourselves since today began, and very soon we'll be heading to the reception where we'll have a lot of celebration, a lot of entertainment, and you can trust us, it's gonna be wonderful.
From there, guests including politicians and prominent leaders and others gather at St. Mary Center event in a collegiate for entertainment. Music by the band. And real cracking of joke by MC Olubunmi Afuye, the fun was unlimited. It is therefore important that we live our lives not for what we can enjoy in heat, but for what we can leave behind for posterity, knowing that death is inevitable for all living things. And here is what people say about leadership D.O Akanle.
I thank God that you guys are celebrating our in-law in this manner today. He was a high chief, he was a good man, and nothing could be less than this.
Ati gba kekere ti won ti je oko egbon mi na ti ko ebi wa mora koda regard him like a son in law. He was regarded like a son to my parents. He was very thoughtful, very careful, and very encouraging.
I'm a very deep person like him because my dad is very deep. He likes things being done quickly. If he wants it done, he wants it done now. And I'm that kind of person. So that's why everybody, they'll go, oh, if you want this to be done, if you don't want someone to be angry, just do it, because they know I'll be angry and I'll be shouting, and that's it. So I took that from my dad.
Building our houses, our barriers, dealing with tenants and everything, that really helped us with his vast experiences.
I'm actually a friend of the family. I became friends with his children, his two daughters, specifically Yetunde and Tope, about 35 years ago. And since then, he's sort of been a father figure in my life. He's been consistently supportive. He calls me Fumi of London. This is a great loss to us, but I know that God will give us the strength to bear this loss. He's a very jovial man.
My name is Harold Azinge. I am married to one of Baba's daughter, Remy Azinge. Daddy was my daddy. I took a liking, loving to daddy, because daddy took me right away like a son. And I really don't want to cry, but I'm trying very hard.
First thing about my dad, apart from faith, is education. Education is very important to him, very, very important. He will tell you that without education is nothing. Then he believes in God, he likes to sing, he's a very happy man. He tells us, like, talk less, listen more. Do you understand? Believe in God that whatever is going to happen, the Lord will computerize. That is my dad's slogan. He lived a very good life, he was a very, very good man.
Baba is funny, Baba is kind, and Baba is just like my own father too, because I saw some similarities with him too, you know. So I must say, Baba, lying here today, it's surprising, but it's something that all of us we go through, you know. And I must say that we will definitely miss Baba.
I lived an enviable life. It was a life worth living. And to have left children like he did before and a wonderful wife behind showed that his life was not in vain. He achieved a lot.
And Favor Digital Watch Crew, we are here to give you the very best of memory of Pa Daniel Omolui Akanle as we give him the final respect. Thank you.
I thank God that you guys are celebrating our in-law in this manner today.
You have done a tremendous job. You've done a very good job. You've been very professional. Keep it up and you'll go places.
May his general soul rest in perfect peace. Olagide reporting for Favor TV News.